ISD police department came over, and we just all ran across the field. And so, of course, I'm leading the pack. And then Coach Swinton at the time was like, "Hey, Buckethead, come here. And what are you running from?" I said, "I'm running from the police." And he said, "Do you want to run track?"
I saw him running, and I'm just laughing with my girlfriend like normal seventh graders, you know, girls do. And we're giggling and laughing. I'm like, "Girl, you see him run?" I'm like, "He runs like a robot. It's just a stiff, straight up and down movement, just like a real robot, you know, but he's moving, and you don't think he's moving, but he's moving."
But Swin was more of the calling you Buckethead. He was just the coach. He introduced me to track and field. And when Coach James came onto the scene, Coach James used to come to the track meets, and I'm like, "Well, who is this skinny coach with these plaid checkerboard suits on and everything?" And Coach James was one of these coaches that he didn't play no games with you. Again, I took the same mentality that I had at O.W. Holmes up to Roosevelt, checks boxes in the gyms, and Coach James came in there, and what he said to me, I wouldn't dare go. I'm not going to say it on camera, but that changed my life forever.
I was one of the fastest linebackers ever at Texas A&M. Track-wise, at Roosevelt, I didn't even run track. We had that many fast guys. When we used to have track meets, the stadium would be full of people, and all of them were just waiting to see Roy run. So every time, no matter how far we were ahead, how far we were behind, we knew when he got the stick, we were going to win. And everybody came to see it. I mean, people were over the fences. They were everywhere out there. It wasn't a seat to be found in the stadium when this man ran.